YouTube, Campervan Kevin here. Well, today I am coming to you from inside my BT Cruiser. A couple things I want to talk to you about. My last video I talked about having an odor inside the BT Cruiser when I'm driving. I let both windows down. It creates some kind of back pressure and it's pulling odors out of my tank. Causing the inside of my RV to smell. I've had, I think I just checked the video, over 420 comments, hundreds and hundreds of people giving me suggestions, and some that I've looked into. I just can't thank you enough. But I believe we got the problem on the run. I'm going to show you what I've attempted to do so far. Now this is my bathroom. Understand, Martha Stewart does not live here. Campervan Kevin does. I've seen how people get ripped apart on their videos about something not being clean. I live in my RV. And so if you see some dirt, something you're not happy with, feel free to come by and we'll set up a time you can clean it for me. But this is how I like to keep things. Now what I did is I went to Walmart and I got a stopper, plugged up my sink, ran water over it. Then my toilet, ran water in it. Then I went and drove it. Same problem. Didn't help a bit. Now you tell me if it's my black tank, how can, Tucker, don't mind me, buddy. We're just shooting a video here. I don't mind, go ahead. Yeah, it's okay. So the only two ways into my black tank are through the toilet and through the sink. Now, last year at RTR, Jeff, a buddy of mine, we replaced the toilet valve. Show you that video right here in the upper right hand corner. I'm thinking, I'm almost certain that I put in a new seat seal underneath that toilet. So if it's the black tank, the only place it can be coming from now is underneath that toilet. And I don't think that's where it is. So, that leaves the gray tank. This problem is somewhat relatively kind of new, kind of, sort of. Reason being, at RV base camp, I usually just leave the gray water open. Gray water hits the ground, I don't mind. It's my property. It's just soap and water. I let it run. So for me to have a gray tank that's closed over 3 or 4 days is kind of unusual. So that leads to me to believe that's coming out of my sinks and my shower drain. Now I've got a stopper. I use these when I'm parked and I don't want to put any water in my tank, in my gray tank. But I got a stopper under this one. I'm going to get another stopper for this one, and then I'm also going to plug my shower. Now my shower is clean. It looked that way when I got it. Someone had left the antifreeze in there too long and it stained it just a little bit. So my next course of action is I'm going to plug off the gray water tank and see if I have the same problem. A lot of people told me about, it's kind of unusual me filming myself. We're going to go with it. A lot of people told me that there might be like a valve underneath my sink in here in the bathroom and my sink in the kitchen, and it works off, it has like a spring and pressure and whatnot that might be broken. I checked, I don't have one of those at all, but they do make those backflow where it lets the water go down but not the odors go out. So that's my next course of action. So I'm just kind of experimenting. Tucker, should I show it to him? Yeah, go ahead. I showed people this little hack not long ago. A lot of people say they liked it. As you can see, I've got the dog food, the water in there, and the dog food storage right there. There's really no place for a trash can. So if you've got a sturdy, these have got to be into the studs. If you've got a sturdy toilet paper holder, you can do the rack the same way there. And I find it perfect. It usually lasts one day, and then I throw out my trash every day. But let me show you one of my little possessions here. Doesn't matter. Doesn't mean much to anybody but me. But this little dog right here is from my childhood. My grandmother Ruth bought this for me, and I was about 3 or 4 years old. And it's dated on the bottom. It is plastic, but I think the date on it's 1970, maybe 71. And I was born in 69. So one of those little silly things that has tons and tons of sentimental value to me, but maybe no one else. But that's my little dog, my little soap holder. A lot of new people to my channel. Have you seen our subscribers? Goodness gracious. It's not gonna be much longer. We're gonna hit 20,000 subs. I think I checked either 2.6 or 2.7 million views. Woo! We must be doing something right. Thank you guys. For all you new people that are watching, welcome to the Campervan Kevin family. I'm glad you're here. I hope you stick around. If you have a chance, go back, look at some of my older videos. A lot of people like Free Yorkie. Why do I have three Yorkies? Bob, the bug out bus. That's my shuttle bus conversion. But you may be asking, Kevin, where's your bathroom door? I took my bathroom door off. It's just me in here. Sorry for the shake. It's just me in here. And even if there wasn't this little flimsy door in a 20-foot RV, if you poop in here, the other person's going to know it. So, you know, I have to kind of abandon ship. Always a good idea. I like having the extra room, and I get the light from my skylight and shower. Well, what's this? This is just a little switch that my buddy David wired in for me for my fan. It was wired directly into when I cut on the light, it came on. Well, I don't always want the fan on. And this is a neat little trick I picked up at an RV place here in Tennessee. LED battery powered. That sucker throws out some light. I hadn't even touched the batteries. I think it was $6. Wish I'd have bought a dozen of them. If I ever go back by there, I am. Also, been talking about the bowling alley floor. I'm going to show you my floor here. You know, to be a 2003 model. Okay, yeah, you got to get in the shot, baby. Okay, oh, sweet babies. And there's me a sweet maymays. Oh, I love my babies. Okay, Tuck. Okay, goodness gracious. Do y'all know when the camera's on? Is there a secret sound that I don't hear? All right, here's my floor. Y'all got a little, just a few little cuts here. Nothing major, but I found out that and a lot of people gave me links for the bowling alley floor. It's just going to be too heavy. It's going to be too thick. Wait, baby, we'll go out in a second. So kind of back to square one here. So I took my sheets out and blankets out and set them outside in the sun, sprayed them down with Febreze, and it's working great. Okay, Your Majesty, let me let you out. This is how I heat my RV during the summer, huh? You're a funny guy. During the winter time, if it's above freezing, I use the little buddy. If it's below freezing, I use the furnace. I use the furnace to keep the pipes from freezing because it blows air around the pipes, where this just keeps the heat inside the RV. You guys have to see where I'm at. Yeah, that's right. I'm 20 foot from the water. If that. Let me go out here and show it to you right quick. Won't you please, please won't you please, please won't you be my neighbor. All right, dogs, abandon ship. All right. Yeah, this is gonna blow their minds, isn't it? Oh, there you go, shorty. There you go, little one. Y'all ready for this? Look at my view. Not gonna go into much about where I'm at right now. I plan on it being the next video. We're having some fires and some cooking and some fishing. It's working out good. Dogs have plenty of room to run. Got my other solar panel out. Got this beautiful poplar tree right here. But it's blocking my solar, and I'm barely having enough. So I'm using my portable 120 watt. Don't ever show it much, but it works real good. So this is my spot. So just a little update video. I want to thank everybody for their replies and trying to help me with my stank, my cabbage smell inside of my RV. I believe process of elimination, we're going to get it. Thank you everybody for the help. Thank you everybody for sending me all the listings on the Bowlingwood floors. Bowlingwood floors, is that right? Bowling alley wood floors. Got it. You guys are great. You guys are the best. How about that? Almost 20,000 subscribers. Thinking about doing a giveaway. I never have done a giveaway. Next video or two, I'll show you what I have in mind. All right, that's going to end the little video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate each and every one of you. And I'll see you again real soon. You guys take care. Bye-bye.